Can early changes in our face possibly be an early sign of dementia? That's what we're going to talk about today in this video. There have been some pretty interesting findings over the past few years where scientists have discovered that the brain impacts our face, and certain changes in our face may be an indication of dementia. Now, this does not mean we can simply look at somebody's face and say, yes, that's dementia, but it does mean our faces hold signs. So my goal here today in this video is to walk through very clearly what the research is showing about how facial changes might be a sign of dementia. Okay, so first, why are scientists even looking at the face? Well, we have known for a long time that dementia affects way more than just the memory impairment that most people think about. Dementia impacts our motor control, how we move our body, the way we express emotions, our automatic nervous system, inflammation, biological aging, subtle changes in muscle movement, and facial responsiveness. And so, because of the understanding that dementia impacts so much, scientists started asking themselves, are there changes that are happening in the face that might show up early before the cognitive symptoms happen? And if so, what are those facial changes? In a way, to kind of help us identify either high-risk individuals or people who are showing very subtle early signs, but it's not significantly impacting their day-to-day life yet. So in 2023, researchers looked at two groups of individuals, adults with dementia and those without. And they analyzed facial movements that are so subtle and small that the unaided eye wouldn't even notice it. And here's what they found. People with dementia showed reduced variation in their facial expression. Their micro movements, facial micro movements, were subtle and slower compared to those without dementia. They specifically had subtle changes in their eye region movement and mouth movement. And machine learning models were able to detect those changes at above chance accuracy, meaning they were picking up on something. It wasn't just random or happen chance about these changes. Now, it's important to note these facial changes that this study revealed were so subtle, it's not like our family members would be able to notice these changes in our loved ones. They're not visible signs to the naked eye. So that was a 2023 study. In 2024, there was another study that talked about and looked at facial changes and dementia risk. This specifically was looking at how old somebody looks and how old they really are. They called this pretty much the facial age gap. And here's what it found. People who look significantly older than their biological age were at a higher risk of developing dementia because looking older is often linked to other underlying symptoms such as inflammation, poor vascular health, and overall biological aging. Now, this doesn't mean looking older means that they're going to get dementia or that they have dementia. However, it does mean that the face can reflect underlying health. We would consider an aging face more so than biological age to be a risk marker, not necessarily a symptom of dementia. And then in this third 2024 study, they basically looked at facial changes in early Alzheimer's disease using highly sensitive software. And what they found again confirmed that people with Alzheimer's disease smiled less often, their emotional responses were slower, and some of their facial movements were slower or more rigid and smaller. Again, these are changes in brain-driven motor and emotional function, not anything obvious to a passive observer. So this research is promising for further clinical tools to help us identify dementia earlier, but these aren't necessarily things we would be looking at ourselves to try to diagnose somebody at home. So what does this research really mean? It means what we already know, dementia affects far more than memory. It affects our changes in our motor control, our expression, And that biological aging can appear early through our looks. What it doesn't mean is that we can't simply diagnose dementia based on looking at somebody. We can't diagnose dementia just simply based on somebody's facial expression. Family members shouldn't try using this information as a screening tool to try to figure out if their loved one has dementia. And no, not everybody who looks older than their age might be at risk for dementia. But these are just some of the earlier stages and earlier studies scientists are looking at in hopes to be able to detect Alzheimer's disease or other dementias earlier. Because the earlier we detect them, the earlier we intervene, the more options there are for treatment, for interventions, and for getting family as prepared as possible for what's ahead. In terms of what you might be feeling as the Careblazer watching this video, many times family members tell me they notice their loved ones have less expression, less smiles. They seem more flat and they don't seem to react emotionally like they used to in the past. And so this kind of research hopefully validates your experience. I know at the time that I'm recording this video, it's December, and many families I work with, they have such high hopes and desire to give their loved ones with dementia a beautiful holiday experience. And it can feel pretty defeating when their loved ones don't show excitement or appreciation or happiness for the gift that they received or the show that they went to or the visitor that stopped by. And so again, this is another message that it doesn't necessarily mean your loved one isn't enjoying what's happening. It just means the dementia is impacting their facial movements and their ability to show expression. So just because it doesn't look a certain way on the outside doesn't mean that's necessarily has anything to do with how they're feeling on the inside. It's just the brain is not moving the facial expressions like it does for you and me. So yes, right now there is some emerging research in how early changes in our facial expressions might be able to help us identify dementia earlier, but no, we are not at the stage yet where we can just evaluate somebody's face and determine whether or not they have dementia. Certainly not by us just looking at somebody with a naked eye. All right, Careblazer, I hope this video was helpful to you. A couple of things. If you're not yet already subscribed to our weekly newsletter. It's called the Dementia Dose. It's totally free. And every week I put out new information, thoughts, tips, strategies, including some Careblazer resources and products that our members love. We share them with you every single week. Also, if you're looking for more support with the community of really loving, supportive Careblazers, as well as a panel of dementia experts where you can come to week after week, day after day to get support and answers to your questions. We are here for you. We offer that through our Care Collective program. Again, all of that is in the description below, as well as links to the studies that I referenced in case you want to go dive deeper into the science yourself. I'm sending you so much love. Bye.
Also, Nico gets a belly rub for every person who subscribes from this video. So if you haven't already, click the red subscribe button. It's totally free. And Nico says, thank you very much.